date is the 21st of October 2011, 0730. This is Flight Lieutenant David Hill, assigned to the 74th Fighter Squadron, currently based at Al Dhafra Air Base in the UAE. Today's sortie is to undertake a familiarisation flight of the Al Dhafra area and weapons and navigation proficiency tests.
Start engines.
Thank you. 1 requesting takeoff.
Gunman 1-1, you are clear for takeoff. Runway 13 left.
Tower, Gunman 2-1, ready to taxi.
Gunman 2-1, permission to taxi. Right turn onto taxiway Alpha, then left turn onto Echo. Hold short runway 13 left.
We tower right onto Alpha, left Echo, hold 13 left.
Field 1-1, request takeoff.
Tower, Goodman 2-1, requesting takeoff.
Goodman 2-1, you are clear for immediate takeoff. Add that for tower out. Gunman 1-1, Gunman 2-1, be advised low-level helos are taking off from Albertine at this time. Observe minimum Angels 3.
1-1, copy. Copy. This is 2-1 approaching your position.
Copy 2-1. I'll talk you through the key navigational landmarks in this area as well as procedures in UAE airspace. We are on a war footing here in the UAE and air defences are in a high state of readiness. No doubt you've picked up the Patriots on your RWR. Head for waypoint 3. I will form on your wing and hold a close formation throughout the flight. So just off the coast of Abu Dhabi is a set of three oil fields. They are important to note as a landmark bearing 270 from Al Dhafra should you ever be struggling in bad visibility. is Ferrari World, an indoor theme park based on, you guessed it, the Yas Marina racetrack is located right next door and hosts Formula One Grand Prix every year. But you probably know more about that than me. It's a Sheikh Zayed Grand Mosque. It's the largest mosque in the country and can hold over 40,000 worshippers. Interestingly, it also holds the world's largest carpet. Very interesting, sir. Let's focus on the important stuff. Currently, the Air Force is maintaining two permanent caps in Emirati airspace, one in the south protecting Al Dhafra, and one in the north covering our E3 tracks. On top of that, we have alert fighters on standby around the clock and a number of Patriot batteries on high alert. Iran knows we are coming for them, and there's a real threat they may attempt preemptive strike. AWACS is monitoring UAE airspace constantly, so we must monitor their freak at all times and be prepared to answer any challenges as required. It's usually a good idea to check in with them as well once airborne. Let's do that now. Switch your VHF AM radio to 128.5 and contact Overlord.
Overlord, Gunman 2-1, checking two ship of 810s on a fan flight out of Al Dhafra.
Gunman 2-1, welcome to the neighborhood. Picture is clean and you're clear to proceed. Overlord out.
Copy, Overlord. Gunman 2-1 out.
Very good, pilot. Continue on to 8.3.
The coastline we're currently flying over is over 130 nautical miles away from Iran, so we can't consider it safe airspace. However, as we fly further north, the gap narrows down to as little as 50 nautical miles at the Straits of Hormuz. There are also a series of Iranian-occupied islands that can be as close as 30 nautical miles off the Emirati coast. These islands do possess SAM systems and will pose a threat if you stray too close to them, so unless your flight plan tells you, stay close to this side of the Gulf. The weather in the UAE is usually great, as you would expect, but there are some important factors to consider. There are usually a number of weather systems over the Gulf area, which means that the weather can vary a bit at times. At this time of year, we tend to see low pressure systems in the Emirates and Gulf, but high pressure systems in Iran. All of which can combine to make things interesting. Whilst it's usually dry, when we do get rain, we tend to get quite big storms. A bigger issue, though, is dust storms, which tend to blow in ahead of new pressure systems. Ours is Dubai. East of Dubai is the other active coalition base in the UAE, Al Minhad. The UAV fleet had run out of there along with a lot of Special Operation Force helos. Beyond Dubai lies the Straits of Hormuz, a narrow stretch of water with Iran on one side of it. A third of the world's gas and 25% of its oil flows through that passage and is of vital strategic importance. When things go hot, that area is going to be busy.
Thank you.
targeting pod checks. If you haven't already done so, power up the landing pod. Once the pod is online, check for correct operation, making sure it slews freely, zoom and FOV changes are working, and the FLIR and CCD modes are all working. I also want you to review your weapons profiles, verifying that all dismissed data is accurate and the settings within the profiles are set and correct. I also suggest you review the IFFCC gun settings and ensure the ammunition type matches what was actually loaded. You'll see details of your loadout on your kneeboard if you can't recall it. Copy.
So I'm assuming Dave is because of David Jones, right, sir?
Yeah, that's right. Got that well struck.
been, sir?
Okay, during advanced training in T-38, I had a really bad day in the cockpit. I won't go into any details, but when I got to the ground, I was pissed. Took out my frustration by punching my locker. Broke two bones in my hand and was off the flying roster for a while. That locker became Davy Jones's locker, and I've carried Davy to this day. Steep, that's a bit different. You gonna share as well? Sure. Whilst I was at university in Lincoln, and that's our Lincoln, not the one in Nebraska, what's the big round building? Never seen anything like that before. Anyway, in the centre of Lincoln is a huge cathedral that sits on top of the big hill and dominates. I know it's called the Aldar HQ. I think it's just offices, but I don't know much more than that. On nights when we had perhaps indulged a bit too much, I used to like to challenge my squadron mates to a race up the hill. The road to the cathedral was literally called a steep hill. Because my surname is Hill, I used to say I was born to run up hills, and we used to make it a thing whenever we were on a night out. I ended up at RAF College with some of those guys. They never let me forget my love of that hill, and so steep I became. Sure, steep hill, that works.
So, Steve, how does the A-10 compare to those Harriers used to fly in Afghanistan?
Sir, I miss the speed of the Harrier, but you've got all of the firepower the Warhawk can bring. I understand why the boots on the ground love having this aircraft above them.
Yeah, the Gowain is something you really want to hear on your side when you're under fire. I can't imagine what it's like to be on the receiving end of it. You know, the Warthog was always the unwanted child in the Air Force. Too slow, too ugly, and too involved with the Army.
But then the Hawks went to Desert Storm. In 91 we knocked out over 900 tanks, 1200 pieces of artillery and over 2000 other vehicles. Oh, and two helicopters. Finally started to get some love then. But you know, they keep trying to retire us. Don't seem to think the US needs our unique capability anymore. Well, tell that to the poor kids taking fire on the ground. You think we'll be in the thick of it once the action starts? Indeed I do. Others may be sexier and faster, but once we have troops in contact, they'll be screaming for us the loudest.
Thank you.
Wingman 2-1 in position.
Okay, Gunman 2-1. I want you to attack the southernmost group of IFEs on an attack axis of 3-2-8. It should be easy to locate. Just follow the dirt track and the other closest group to your position. For this attack, use the gun. You'll need to watch your background on this to use a high angle strafe. You are clear and hard. Let me know when you have finished your attack. I'm just looking to see if you can hit the target, nothing more.
Attack vector looks good. Shoot at around 1 mile slant range.
Followed that correct attack direction. This removes the threat of dropping short or long on friendly forces. Return to the Angels 5 and hold in an orbit 5 miles north of the range. Let me know when you're in position.
Thank you. Command 2-1 in position.
Your next task is to conduct a precision strike on a target building using a GBU-12, avoiding the adjacent buildings in the process. The target is 4,000 feet north of your previous target. It's a one-story garage with a car parked outside. Locate the target with your landing pod and let me know when you have a positive ID.
to ITP.
Okay, pilot, let's head home. Why not use TACAN for our return? The channel for Aldafra is in your kneeboard. I'm gonna reform on your wing and we'll head back in formation.
How long have you been in the Air Force, sir?
I've been in 13 years now, and apart from training, it's all been in the hog.
You see any action in Iraq or Afghanistan?
Yes, Deep. I did 2 tours in Afghanistan as part of Enduring Freedom. Got a lot of tricky time over there as well. You were over there with the RAF. You know how it was.
I never felt in danger. We had such a permissive environment, but the pressure of not screwing up with the boys on the ground needed us was tough.
At least you weren't on the ground.
Roger that, sir. I'd rather be up here. You support a lot of troops in contact.
Hell, Steve, yeah. Well, the danger close as well. You know, as impersonal as a prosecution of a target can be in an airplane. It sure feels more personal when you got a fag scared out of his wits trying to talk you on target to save the lives of him and his buddies. That's why we train so hard for the CAS mission and work on avoiding blue-on-blues. I've seen what it does to both the ground forces and the pilot. It ain't good anyway you look at it.
How do you think the war will go?
I think we'll dominate the air. It'll run its teeth sure, but we have too much strength for them in the air. It's the ground that concerns me. We don't have a great track record of toppling regimes and stabilizing and transitioning countries in this part of the world, do we?
I agree.
I mean, we might smash the IRGC like we smashed the Iraqis in 91 and 03. But why after? That's always the hard bit. But whenever it happens, at least there will be CAS on hand.
Gunman 2-1, we are approaching Aldafra. Contact them and obtain landing clearance. 21 requesting permission to land.
Gunman 21, you are cleared for landing, runway 31 right.
Pilot, good work today. I'll follow you in and watch you down. When back on the ground, taxi back to the 70th horse parking area. I'll see you later for the debrief. Gunman 11 out.